Welcome Shreya Rastogi as we congratulate her to be the alumni of the month for ABS. So, first of all, we would like to know your experiences in ABS and what were those key learnings that you took from the classes, from the moments that you enjoyed at the cafeteria while sitting in the auditorium.
Nice to be here, first of all. And I remember being there as well, and people coming here and saying this, ki we remember being there as well. And it's altogether a very nice feeling. And coming back to college is always like, you know, you feel a wave of memories coming all together. So I remember when we started with the college, of course you are so excited, you are starting with your college, you are actually entering an altogether a new phase. Why a new phase? Because you are not only getting educated for the sake of being educated, you are basically getting to learn how you'll be surviving out there in the world. So it's a very initial step, and there are a lot of things that you don't realize when you are on the other side, because it's all fun, chill. College mein kya hi hota hai, kuch bhi nahi hota hai. Bulate hai, padhate rehte hai, kuch kaam nahi aata hai, sab kaam aata hai. Trust me, sab kaam aata hai. And the moment you will actually start understanding or start the applying whatever you're learning around in the college, you will understand how it's actually helping you. So that was even the case, I believe, when I joined. So for the first one and a half months, it's all fun, it's all chill. You do not want to attend the classes. You want to be out there with your friends, sit in the cafeteria all day. And we have very good music in the cafeteria, of course. So you can enjoy that. But once you start paying attention to what are the subjects, what is being taught, what other teachers actually saying when you are attending those lectures, you get to realize that you'll have to pay simultaneous attention to the studies as well. Of course, I'm not saying ki maze karna chhodo, that's the end of everything. Wo mat karna chhodo. 40% maze karlo, 60% bhi padhai karloge na, to you'll actually realize that what is needed to grow in life. And it is not a one-time thing ki aap ek din apna man laga loge padhai mein, agle din nahi lagaoge. So once you start applying it, padhai mein man khud hi lag jata hai. So lagana nahi padta hai, because you're no more students. Ab school nahi ja rahe ho, you're no more I'll say rotifying things and writing on the exam sheets. You have the liberty of actually expressing yourself in front of your teachers. So that's what I did. I don't remember rotifying a lot. I don't remember mugging up chapters. I don't even remember, I believe, mugging up definitions. Jo likhna zaruri hota hai. So what I remember is just understanding whatever the teachers are saying, understanding the concepts around it, and then basically applying it. So application is the whole gist of it. You just have to know how to apply things, be it in terms of what the teachers are saying, or be it in terms of even the co-curricular activities. You feel like the seminars and the guest lectures, they are, I believe, a waste of time maybe. How many of you feel this way? Like, teachers won't look back and you guys can look somewhere else.
I am sitting here, I will not say anything about it.
But I believe we can have a separate poll after this. So for those who feel like guest lectures are not even important, they are important. It all depends if you're attending a 30-minute guest lecture, if you're listening to a teacher for 30 minutes and you're able to have a takeaway of, let's say, 3 minutes as well, it works. So I remember we have had a lot of guest lectures, we have had a lot of workshops, we have had a lot of seminars, and I have been a part of, I believe, all the guest lectures, all seminars, all workshops. Pata nahi hai wahan par kya karna hai, but I used to be there. So I believe that really takes you a long way, because these are the things that you imbibe in yourself from college, and once you start working, these come handy, because aapko shuru se aadat hai of taking part, being a leader, or taking ownership. So that resonates once you start working. So I believe this is how I have experienced my college.
Okay, so anyways, coming to your, the corporate part, your professional life, before joining Zomato, you had worked with Expand My Business, which is also Asia's largest managed marketplace for digital services. So we would like to know your experience there as you got to work there. So I'm sure the experience must have been a great, you know, and you can probably share it with us, with our students.
Okay, so a lot of us have dilemmas ki startup join karna chahiye or we should go for a brand, for a company. How many of you actually have thought about this dilemma? Okay, so I believe a lot of you have actually thought about it, and believe me, startup bhi kar liya hai and now I'm working with Zomato, so I have seen both the sides. I will not give you an advice ki you should go for a startup first or you should go for a brand first. It's all up to you. How do you want to go about it? But I can tell you how it feels working in a startup and working with a brand like Zomato. A startup, it gives you an opportunity to actually have an ownership of your work, because वहाँ पे भी उनको नहीं पता वो क्या कर रहे हैं. Believe me, startups, they do not know what they are doing. They have no idea where they are heading. They have a goal, they have a target, they have a vision, of course, but the path to it is not defined by them. You can be the person to define that. It all depends you what kind of ownership you have while you're working, what you are putting onto the table. So whenever you are entering in any office, in any workplace, thing that matters is how you are presenting yourself. Whether do you want to be a person who is laid back in work or who is just ensuring that bare minimum is achieved, or are you the person who sets standards, who is actually entering in a workplace with a mindset that I bring a work ethic which can actually put me way ahead of other people's, even though I'm a fresher. So that kind of an attitude will actually help you in understanding that how can you place yourself at a workplace rather than how a workplace is placing you in their team. So while working with Expand My Business, there have been so many days that I believe we have worked for 11, 12 hours as well. We had early mornings, late nights, some late nights were because of course partying. But you had to show up for early mornings. So therein you actually realize that whether you are actually working for your passion or not, because when you are working in tedious schedules and you get tired, you do not feel like working or do not feel like going to the office, you are not actually in the right work environment, or you are not actually working with the right people. So Expand My Business, I had a great experience with them. I wanted to go to the office every day. I wanted to work for the purpose, and not for the fact that they were paying me X amount of money or I was supposed to show at 10 a.m. in the morning, but because I had a belief that this place can actually take me somewhere. I have no clue Expand My Business as an entity wo kahan tak pahunchenge, mujhe aaj bhi nahi pata. But I know that whatever I have contributed in that organization while being there has contributed a lot to me and to what I am today, or to what I have learned that I'm implementing in Zomato at present. So basically it's Zomato, it's not Zomato. So they had a very wonderful campaign of Zomato and Zomato. So they are basically Zomato. And whatever I learned at Expand My Business, I get to implement that. And Zomato as a workplace is again a wonderful place, a beautiful place to work. They have a beautiful office, a collaborative team. And collaboration is again something that really takes you a long way, because once you enter in an organization, there, for an example, there is a team of 15 people working. They already have their ways of working. When a new person comes in, that it's the responsibility of that person to be collaborative enough to ensure that you get on the same page as others. You cannot expect other people to come and talk to you. You'll have to take that initiative and make space for yourself. And this is a very, I'll say, famous quote which works on social media, that take space. Do take space. When you take space, you make your own personality, you make your own aura. It helps you. It does.